What's up guys, it's Adam here and welcome to my review of Kaspersky Secure Connection VPN. Now, as a VPN from a leading cybersecurity company, you'd expect Kaspersky Secure Connection to have high standards. Still, its privacy policy has always concerned me because of its suspicious connections with the Russian FBS. Also, the US government has banned the use of Kaspersky software within its regions, which raises further concerns. So, after conducting my testing and research on them, I can say that Kaspersky Secure Connection isn't a safe choice for privacy enthusiasts. It keeps more logs than most VPNs, and it's still associated with its Russian accusations. However, it provides fast speeds and high-quality security features, giving you adequate protection from online threats like hackers, and I'll talk more on that later in this review. Okay, so right out of the gate, if you're not overly worried about privacy, then I can still recommend Kaspersky Secure Connection. Its low price makes it a great deal, and you can claim a full refund within 30 days if you're not satisfied. But if you're concerned about its privacy or it doesn't work out for you, then there are other options out there, like ExpressVPN, which has a true real no logs policy that has none of the privacy issues. And in case you'd like to learn more about Express, I'll put additional information in the description below. Okay, so like my other reviews, I started things off with a speed test. In fact, I was pleasantly surprised by how fast and consistent Kaspersky speeds were. Actually, the speeds were fast on both its short and long distance servers, and I could do all of my usual online activities without interruption. Now, to test its speeds, I used Ookla's speed test tool, which tested the download speed, upload speed, and ping. So then, what about local speeds? Well, to get a baseline for my speed tests, I tested my local non-VPN connection in the UK, and the results showed a download speed of 51 megabits per second, an upload speed of 20.8 megabits per second, and a ping of 5 milliseconds. Next, when I connected to a Kaspersky server in the UK, my speed dropped significantly. Now, it's very common for speeds to drop on a VPN connection because the internet traffic has to travel further distance. Now, it's very common for speeds to drop on a VPN connection because the internet traffic has to travel a further distance, and it goes through more layers of encryption. However, it was still fast enough for HD, and it easily surpassed my expectations. With Kaspersky on, my download speed dropped to 29.7 megabits per second, the upload speed was 9.68 megabits per second, and a ping rose to 238 milliseconds. And while it might seem like a massive difference by the numbers, that was hardly the case. Actually, I expected my speed to drop even further on its long distance servers, and even though I expected it to fall, it didn't drop to the extent that I did expect. In fact, its long distance speeds were very similar to its local servers. The servers I tested first were its US and Australian servers, probably the two most common server locations for accessing international shows. When connected to the Kaspersky US server, my download speed dropped to 21.9 megabits per second, with an upload speed of 7 megabits per second and a ping of 223 milliseconds. Then, as for the Australian server, my connection speed dropped to 22.5 megabits per second, the upload speed was 5.65 megabits per second, and a ping of 327 milliseconds. From there, I tested a wide range of different servers in various parts of the world, and the speeds were similar and pretty quick. Compared to the local connections, the long distance connections took a little longer to download videos on YouTube, but I didn't experience any lag during movies. Overall, I was pretty amazed at Kaspersky's speeds and consistency, which puts it right up with the best VPNs. Okay, so as for Kaspersky's server network, I would describe it as small but secure. Yes, with 500 servers in only 30 countries, Kaspersky's server network is small for a paid VPN. Their list includes major countries like the US, UK, France, Australia, Japan, Russia, and Turkey. Unfortunately, you can only choose the server location and not the exact server, which I found to be disappointing for a paid VPN. However, it does give you unlimited server switches. Kaspersky also has thousands of IP addresses, which include both dynamic and static IPs. A dynamic IP address changes every time you use the VPN, whereas a static one stays the same. With Kaspersky, you have the choice of using either, so this is very handy. Now, Even though Kaspersky uses Hotspot Shield's Hydra VPN technology, their server networks are entirely different. However, it leases its infrastructure from Hotspot Shield, which means that Kaspersky rents its servers. Since Hotspot is a secure VPN that's had independent audits, it's safe to say that Kaspersky's rented servers are reasonably safe. Then, as for security, despite a history of issues, I would say that Kaspersky Secure Connection is in decent shape. However, the parent company of Kaspersky Secure Connection, Kaspersky Lab, had its technologies infected by a type of malware called Dooku 2.0 in 2015, and Dooku 2.0 is well known for infecting hotel computers in Australia and Switzerland. Now, it had infected Kaspersky Lab's technologies for several months without being detected. Luckily, Kaspersky Lab used the knowledge gained from this attack to improve their defensive technologies, so you could say that it's had a positive effect. Then in 2019, Kaspersky passed an audit that a Big Four company conducted. The audit carefully examined the five fundamental principles of security, which include availability, protection, process integrity, confidentiality, and privacy. Now, to review these concepts, the Big Four company looked at Kaspersky Lab services, systems interactions, process controls, user control tools, and service risks. And the end result was that all of Kaspersky Lab's services were well protected against external threats. However, it is strange that the audit is only available to clients with a business account with Kaspersky Lab. Okay, so what about encryption and security protocols? Well, Kaspersky Secure Connection uses the OpenVPN protocol on Android and iOS, and Hotspot Shield's Catapult Hydra protocol on Windows and macOS. Now, unlike other top-tier VPNs, you cannot change protocol settings with Kaspersky, meaning that the two protocols listed are automatically selected by default. For example, ExpressVPN allows you to change your settings and also uses OpenVPN. So, just to give you a little background on these features, OpenVPN is a standard VPN protocol that's commonly used and highly configurable with plenty of port types. And it's well known for balancing speed and security, as well as being an open sourced protocol. This means its source code is hosted publicly on the internet, which provides excellent transparency. Now, Catapult Hydra, on the other hand, is unique to Hotspot Shield. It establishes secure connections and strong encryption by using TLS-based security. Sure, this level of protection is among the strongest for the transfer of data. However, since Catapult Hydra's information level is limited, it hasn't quite proved its worthiness like OpenVPN. But if you use an outdated network or service, you can choose to use other protocols like IKEv2, SSTP, and L2TP/IPsec. Also, Kaspersky Secure Connection doesn't support WireGuard on any of its apps. Thankfully, Kaspersky uses AES 256-bit encryption, which is the gold standard of encryption. Actually, it's commonly referred to as military-grade encryption and is used by top intelligence agencies worldwide to protect sensitive information. In fact, the processing power required to break this encryption is so big that it'll take more than a few lifetimes for the world's strongest supercomputers to crack. So, you can be assured that your data is protected to the highest degree. Also, your DNS requests are protected from DNS leaks with Kaspersky. A DNS leak is a security flaw that accidentally leaks your IP address to your ISP, which can then leak your online data and activity to unauthorized third parties. This type of leak usually happens because of a VPN misconfiguration. So, to make sure that Kaspersky protects against DNS leaks, I ran a few tests on ipleaks.net, and when I connected to Kaspersky servers in the US, UK, France, Japan, and Russia, my DNS results weren't leaked at all. Now, another security feature worth mentioning is the kill switch that prevents your online data from being intercepted if the connection unexpectedly drops. In the end, the only security features it lacks are split tunneling and multi-hop servers, also known as double VPN. Not having this option means you can't divide your internet traffic between VPN and non-VPN traffic and connect to two different servers for extra security. Then, as for privacy with Kaspersky, well, it's not great. Fortunately, Kaspersky Secure Connection is located in Russia, which is outside of the 14 Eyes Alliance. However, Russia has its own controversies around internet freedoms and privacy. In fact, it only allows VPNs that have been approved by the Russian government. However, Kaspersky appears to be making an effort to steer away from the Russian controversy. Most notably, they've moved their core processes from Russia to Switzerland, and they've started a global transparency initiative. This initiative aims to capture the attention of the broader cybersecurity community to verify the trustworthiness of its products. Still, many countries are concerned about their practices, and rightly so. Kaspersky Lab owns Kaspersky Secure Connection, which is a world-renowned cybersecurity company in Russia. Apart from the VPN, it provides antivirus software, cloud storage solutions, endpoint security, and password management software, among other cybersecurity products and services. To help rid itself of questionable allegations, Kaspersky Secure Connection has solicited independent reviews and audits of its products and services. It has also moved a lot of its main infrastructure from Russia to Switzerland, alleviating such concerns. Another privacy policy to consider is logging practices. Yes, Kaspersky Secure Connection admits to some logging practices. While it's common for VPN providers to collect some user data to improve their services, Kaspersky's extent is problematic because it states that it will hand your data over to authorities if you violate their terms and conditions. And if that's not concerning enough, it is not well known what even constitutes a violation of their terms, but personal data would have to be collected to identify individuals and report them should the situation arise. Also, Kaspersky uses the same infrastructure as Hotspot Shield, another VPN provider based in California. And even though Hotspot Shield claims to not record any logs of online activity, they make it clear that they collect the same data like your location, session durations, and IP address. Combine all of this with Kaspersky's questionable policies, and you have every reason to be worried. And that is a shame considering that they're pretty generous with their support for simultaneous device connections. Kaspersky allows up to 5 simultaneous device connections under one subscription. And when I tested this by connecting my Windows laptop, Android tablet, smartphone, and old MacBook Pro, it worked. Kaspersky Secure Connection ran smoothly on all of my devices while protecting them at the same time. But the bad news is that there's no way to increase the number from 5. Now, many VPNs can be installed on home routers to enable unlimited device connections at home, but Kaspersky can't be installed on these home routers. Also, they keep track of all connected devices, which again raises some questions for security and privacy. So next, as for device compatibility, well, major operating systems like Windows, Mac OS, Android and iOS are compatible with Kaspersky Secure Connection, but not Linux. It has a native app for these systems, and there's no need for manual configuration. What's odd is that it has separate user agreements for each device. Also, devices that can't support apps like gaming consoles and home routers aren't compatible with Kaspersky. And it doesn't have any browser extensions for Chrome and Firefox, which means you can't use it on a Chromebook either. Now, on the upside, I found that nothing is complicated or technical when using Kaspersky's apps. Its home interface on the desktop has an on and off switch at the top, the VPN server location on the left, and your current version on the right. Then, clicking on the server location lets you choose the country you want, while clicking on the current version takes you to your subscription settings. You can connect to the fastest server under locations, which is the one that's closest to you. Next, the left-hand side has a taskbar, which provides a wide range of options. This includes a Useful to Know tab, which lays out all of the features and benefits of the VPN, and an Other Devices tab, which provides a QR code. It's nice that once you scan the QR code on another device, it will take you straight to the Kaspersky download page, making it much easier to download and install the app. Also, the Settings tab lets you enable and disable the kill switch, the smart protection, and notifications. You can also choose to open the app at the computer's startup or automatically connect to a server when opening the app. Or you can manage your profile and request technical support should you wish. Okay, its mobile apps are not so different from the desktop ones. The interface lets you turn the connection on or off and select the server location. When you go to settings, you can see the kill switch, notifications and account settings and change them. The Android app has a user rating of 4.3 and the iOS app has a rating of 4.7, showing their user-friendly nature. In short, Kaspersky Secure Connection has intuitive apps that are great for newer VPN users, but more advanced users may be disappointed due to the lack of technical settings. Okay, so I've had some mixed results when setting up and installing this VPN on my devices. So downloading the app was straightforward and quick, but installing it on my laptop took much longer. Also, I found it kind of confusing getting the correct app from its website because it didn't distinguish between the free and paid versions. Also, its 30-day money-back guarantee was nowhere to be seen until the checkout section. It would have been helpful had this have been mentioned earlier. Then once I downloaded the app, it took me just about 5 minutes to complete the installation. Now, this may not sound terrible, but other VPNs take nowhere near as long, so I was surprised. Next, once the app was installed, I had to create a Kaspersky account and then log in using my email and password, which was easy. Actually, it was much easier to install the Android app on my smartphone, mainly because I could scan the QR code on the desktop app. And once I'd scanned the QR code, it took me to the Google App Store to download the Android app, which was easily downloadable. After downloading it, I just had to open it and log in, which took under 1 minute. So, what about the cost? Okay, Kaspersky has three pricing plans, including a free, monthly, and a yearly plan. Of course, compared to the paid plans, the free plan is very basic and comes with limitations, including 200 megabytes of data per day, a reduced server count, and no simultaneous device connections. Or you can buy it as part of a bundled package with other Kaspersky software like the antivirus or password manager. So the monthly plan costs around $5 a month, while the yearly plan costs about $3 a month. So compared to Hotspot Shield, which uses the same infrastructure, Kaspersky is much cheaper. However, you can only make payments with a credit card or PayPal, not through other methods like cryptocurrencies. Fortunately, both paid plans come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you can test everything before committing. But the UK version only comes with a 14-day money-back guarantee, so to test this out, I asked to cancel my subscription through its technical support channel on day 12. I then got a reply after 16 hours and they agreed to refund my payment. Once it was confirmed, it took me 5 business days to receive my full refund, which was a bit longer than expected. So even though that Kaspersky does come out at a lower price, that price isn't exactly worthwhile considering the privacy issues. Lastly, I want to look at their reliability and support. So there isn't a live chat option on the Kaspersky website, which means you can't get an instant reply to your questions, and you can't even email them, which is even more frustrating. Instead, they direct you to their support documents for all of Kaspersky Lab's products. Because of this, it took me longer than expected to find the answer to my question on protocols. However, you can enter a technical support ticket under your Kaspersky Lab account if you need to speak to someone. When I tried it, I got a reply after 16 hours, which wasn't bad. The response I got was very detailed, friendly, and polite, which surprised me. Then, in addition to these two support channels, it also has a community page where you can ask questions of other Kaspersky users and an FAQ page with answers to general questions. Also, you can scan files and links to check for malware threats and a decryption tool to help with ransomware protection. So, even though Kaspersky's response to my support ticket was detailed, the lack of live chat and email was disappointing. Overall, the readily available information seemed cumbersome and I felt that there were too many pieces to sort through. A simple FAQ section with live chat and email options would have been more sufficient. Okay, so in summary, I'd say that Kaspersky Secure Connection still raises several red flags when it comes to privacy. Its logging policy is vague, it has been compliant with Russian legislation, and it can't shake off its perceived connections with the Russian FBS. However, its speeds and security are right up there with top-tier VPNs, and its price is very competitive. Aside from its privacy, it isn't the greatest for international movies and shows either. It struggles to access a lot of the popular sites. There are other VPNs out there that are much, much better. Still, if you want to use a VPN that offers great value for the price, Kaspersky Secure Connection might be worth trying. And by using its 30-day money-back guarantee, you can even test out all of the features before fully committing to an ongoing subscription. Okay, thank you so much for watching my video. Just a reminder, if you are interested in trying out ExpressVPN, which is my recommended alternative to Kaspersky, be sure to check out the special discount link that I'll put down in the description below. If you have any questions, leave a comment in the comment section and don't forget to like this video if you found my review helpful. And subscribe to my channel if you want to stay up to date on the latest VPNs.